sure if you know this, but when we first met, I got so nervous, I couldn't speak. In that very moment, I found the one, and my life had found its missing piece. So as long as I live, I love you. Will heaven hold you? You look so beautiful in white, and from now to my very last breath, this day I'll cherish. You look so beautiful in white tonight. What we have is time. My love is endless, and with this ring I say to the world, you're my every reason, you're all that I believe in. With all my heart I mean every word. So as long as I live, I love you. Will heaven hold you?
Yes. You also said yeah. Thank you. Congrats, sister. I'm so happy for you. And thank you for making my sister so happy as well. Congrats to the both of you.
my angel in the night. You are my love, my angel in the night. You are my love, love of my life.
A little bit of information on Alvin and Yvonne. They are both engineering graduates from the National University of Singapore. Now, before Alvin went to NUS for his degree, he studied at the Hwa Chong Junior College, right? Yeah, okay. And guess what? 50 years ago, I also studied at the same junior college, you know? So isn't that a nice coincidence? But anyway, unfortunately, he doesn't support the same football club as I do. He is a supporter of Manchester United. And as you know, I'm a fan of Liverpool. Finally, I have to thank my wife, Judith, for organizing this event. She has, a pillar of strength to me. Score points, man. Okay, so enjoy the drinks, the food, and have a safe trip back afterwards. Thank you very much.
A unique blend of love, admiration, and just the right amount of sibling rivalry. Yvonne, being the eldest, didn't always have the same opportunities, but she still excelled on her very own efforts. She consistently taught her class with minimal help, and she also had a natural talent for art and music, which is something that I could never master. I didn't hesitate to go to Singapore for my secondary education because I knew that I always had my big sister to rely on. And while some might think that I studied accounting because of our dad, it was actually because of Yvonne when I saw how challenging chemical engineering was as a degree. But if you know Yvonne, she doesn't give up easily. And she's still an accomplished engineer today. When I was younger, I used to think that I was lucky to be the middle child, free from the responsibilities of being the eldest, and from the attention of being the baby of the family. But now that I'm older, and hopefully a little wiser, I know now that my true fortune was having an older sister as caring, supportive, and loving as Yvonne. So, I'm not sure if you're familiar with the five love languages. Let me introduce you to the Qing system of languages. The first one being dessert. No matter how full we are, there's always room for something sweet. Dessert isn't just a treat, it's a tradition. The second being K-pop. We all love music, but nothing brings us quite together like BTS. And if there's one word to describe my sister, is that she is super generous. I'll never forget the time she bought me tickets to BTS, not just once, but twice. And the third love language is, drumroll, shopping! We could spend hours in the fitting room, but the best part is we get to share each other's clothes, just like my sister here. She's wearing the same exact clothes that my elder sister wore on the previous wedding. I knew that Alvin was perfect for Yvonne because he not only speaks all the Qing sister love languages, but he brings her so much more. Together, they've been on countless adventures, and I know that there are plenty more in store. I'm grateful that Yvonne has found someone older, but more importantly, wiser, to look up to, just as I've always looked up to her. So, here's to Yvonne and Alvin, and may your life together be filled with love, laughter, plenty more desserts, and K-pop concerts together! Let's cheer!
can hurt. Loving can hurt sometimes, but it's the only thing that I know. When it gets hard, you know it can get hard sometimes. It is the only thing that makes us feel alive. We keep this love in a photograph. We made these memories for ourselves, where our eyes are never closing, hearts are never broken, and time's forever frozen still. So you can keep me inside the pocket of your ripped jeans, holding me closer till our eyes meet. You won't ever be alone. Wait for me to come home. Loving can heal, loving can mend your soul, and it's the only thing that I know. No, I swear it will get easier. Remember that with every piece of you. And it's the only thing we take with us when we die. We made these memories for ourselves, where our eyes are never closing, hearts were never broken, time's forever frozen still. So you can keep me inside the pocket of your ripped jeans, holding me closer till our eyes meet. Through the phone, wait for me to come home.
Bye bye. 안녕.
안녕. Bye bye.
Ladies and gentlemen, please keep your applause going as we invite the beautiful bride and the handsome groom to join us.
Thank you.
of champagne symbolizes an everlasting marriage. Your blessings towards this beautiful couple, but I just want to ask, is the ang pao enough? Because nowadays we have like the touch and go QR code, right? So it is also good that you have your QR code printed out, lah. If not enough, lah. I'm joking. Most importantly, is there blessings for both of you, right? So this toast, both of you have to shout louder, okay? Yeah, are you ready? Okay, once again, in the count of three.
I'm so happy to see all of you here in Penang finally, and it's for my wedding. Next, I would like to thank Uncle Richard and Auntie Cindy again, now Mom and Dad, for always being so welcoming, so generous with me, and I am always beyond grateful for your warm hospitality, and thrilled to have you in Penang for this celebration. Thank you for always making sure I'm well fed, always asking me whether I'm hungry or I need food. This time, please let us do the same for you in Penang. Next, shout out to my very dear friend Ruth. Yeah, Ruth and Eugene, thanks for coming. So Ruth, I've known her since I first went to Singapore 17 years ago. Thank you for planning our recent trip to Perth, which was a very nice respite from wedding planning. I'm still amazed by how much we did over 5 days. The minute I told Ruth I was getting married, she immediately said, "When is the Penang wedding? When can I buy tickets?" So I always know that I can count on her. Yeah. And I hope that our friendship continues for the longest time. Thank you to my parents, mommy and daddy, for planning this entire wedding. I know it's not easy because I also did the same in Singapore, so really thank you for planning and organizing everything as we were both still in Singapore. This will definitely be a core memory in my book. I am forever grateful to you for working hard to provide me with the best childhood and subsequently the opportunity to move to Singapore. I will still visit Penang often, and even after we are married, and I hope that we can go on more family trips together soon. Lastly, I'd like to thank my best friend, my now husband, Alvin, for being my biggest cheerleader, keeping me sane and alive throughout preparations, and remembering everything I tend to forget. You're really the missing piece I never knew I needed in my life, and I'm so grateful that I found you. So, I'll end with an interesting story about us. So when I first purchased my home in Singapore, the original seller, she asked me, are you single? Which I was at the time. So then she told me that I'll be super what or super lucky. So I was quite surprised. I said, why? She said, because when she also purchased her first home that time, she was single. Then after a year later, she found her future husband, just within a year. So she told me that I'll be very lucky and find my next true love within a year. So, and that was true. So yes, I'd like to thank everybody who encouraged me that time, because I was very scared, very afraid to make my first big purchase, as I've gotten something even more priceless in the end. Thank you.
And now, Alvin, is it your turn to say a few words? Okay. More than a few words.
Good afternoon to all guests for coming for our wedding luncheon. Thank you so much. I thought I'll have a shorter speech than Yvonne because, you know, I'm from Singapore. But somehow I still end up with a longer speech. I don't know why. Okay, so apologies for the length. First of all, apologies for the not so good dancing just now. Okay, we did it once in September. But it's October now, so yeah, forgot a bit already. Yeah. It's been 2 weeks since we officially got married in Singapore. So far, so good. Yeah. A little bit about myself and Yvonne. We met online on a dating app, like many modern couples. Unlike many modern couples, however, we did not get together fast and furiously. It took us over a year of chatting and being two people who just enjoy each other's presence in the other's life to get together. When I get together with someone, it's often with the end goal of marriage, starting a family and growing old together. Only Yvonne truly convinced me that she's the one who's going to last the distance with me. She's the greatest compliment to my quirkiness, my partner in crime, my audience for numerous bad jokes, sometimes good ones. She always has my back and always smiling to drive away any troubles. Thank you, dear, for being born, for growing up well, and for entering my life. I first came to Penang 2 years ago with Yvonne to meet Yvonne's family shortly after we got together officially. It was also the first non-work related trip I made since COVID broke out, and I wanted to accompany Yvonne back to finally see Penang again. I got to experience the Malaysian hospitality and friendliness from everybody and the warmth of Yvonne's family. To mom and dad, thank you once again for welcoming me into the family with such open arms. You have continuously shown me the merits of being sincere and good to those around you. I see these qualities in Yvonne, and I will also strive to be like that. Yeah, and to that, since I've been to Old Trafford, right, I wouldn't mind paying a visit to Anfield as well. It's never too late to be exposed to something new. Okay, the next And then I got to meet the extended families of Erin and Ignatius' wedding at Rasa Sayang 2 years back. That was when I was so impressed also with Yvonne, because she was greeting everybody so warmly and happily. Honestly, that was very charming to me, and you know, I fell in love with her once more. Yep. So thank you to Yvonne's extended family for your positive influences on her. She has shared fondly of her growing up years, playing TV and PC games with the cousins, being taken care of by Auntie Pauline, and all those yearly Chinese New Year visits to Sitiawan. I'm very excited to join as well and to see Sitiawan as well. The colleagues are back. To her most dearest colleagues from Illumina who came to Penang, I'm sure Yvonne is feeling very FOMO now for not being able to feast on Penang's good food with all of you, okay? Because you're her supper buddies, okay? As Yvonne's relatives all want Yvonne to eat more after this wedding, please continue to jio her for more makan sessions. Yes, this is Tuaku, Eyi, Eyi Zhang, San Yi, San Yi Zhang, 陪我的爸爸妈妈, 搭长途巴士来槟城. San Yi, 老人不麻烦啦, 孝敬你们是我们做晚辈应该做的. 谢谢你们对我和 Alan 那么多年的照顾和关心。 Thank you to my friends who made the trip to Penang. Huan Chao over there with the colleagues. He's our firefighter and fire safety officer for today's banquet. So no worries, everybody's safety is taken care of. But on a serious note, Huan Chao, thank you for coming for both wedding banquets. I hope the alcohol has been sufficient for you. And to Ruth and Eugene as well, you all are like the first friends of Yvonne that I got to know. Thanks for coming, you know, for us, for the second banquet once again. And of course, for helping us to get together as well. Although I know you were like spying and whatever. Thank you.
Paradise, this world that I found is too good to be true.